With the shark model done, my render complete, I'm ready to save my file and to keep all of this, all of my scene information encapsulated and preserved inside of a Blender file. And as one might imagine, by going to the file, save or save as option in the pull-down menu, we're going to be able to save a local file of this project file on my computer. And there's a couple things in here that I want you to be aware of that will help out. First and foremost, the extension for all of our Blender files is .blend. This is the universal file format for Blender only, so this can only be opened in Blender. If we wanted to export this model so that we can send it to a different application like Unity or Unreal or Substance Painter, we need to do that separately. We just can't send our .blend over into Substance Painter. We'd need to export out an OBJ file or an FBX file. So keep that in mind. This is a Blender-specific file, which is pretty robust. Actually, it's a very strong file format. More on that later. There's a lot of functionality in here. When you're saving your files, you're going to be using this Blender Finder system. It's going to be different from your operating system's Finder, but you're going to find that it's pretty straightforward. You can navigate. You can actually save some recents, some bookmarks and stuff. It's a pretty neat little file explorer here that will help you navigate to the areas on your computer very, very quickly. There's a couple of things in here that I want you to see very directly. Notice that I'm naming my project file Hammerhead Shark V001. Well, why V001? I always include a version number in here. Version 1 of this project file didn't include the lighting setup or the mirrored fins. I want to save that just in case I want to go back. So I want to save a different version. Having multiple versions of the exact same project file kind of gives you a history of this project. It allows you to go back in time. Maybe your file gets corrupted, which happens from time to time. Having multiple versions allows you to go back in time a step or two to preserve some of your project. So I'm ready to create a new version of this. Now, I could go down in here and do version 2 like that. That's cool. Here's another trick. See this little plus and minus sign? This is how cool Blender is. This is going to increase and decrease the number at the end of your version, which I think is just so cool. It's the small little things sometimes that just really makes a difference. So I'm going to hit the little plus sign, and now I'm going to save version 2 of my Blender file. So hit save as, and life is good. So saving your files inside of Blender is very, very easy. Of course, the challenge is always making sure that you understand and that you know where these files are saved on your machine. At the end of every project, you're always going to be submitting two things: a JPEG render of your project and your Blender file, or whatever the project file is. We're going to be working in Maya. We're also going to be working in Substance Painter from time to time. So you're going to be submitting JPEGs and project files. And this is how you save your project file here in Blender.